Tomorrow, Uganda joins the rest of the world to celebrate Hospice and Palliative Care Day, with only 55,000 accounting for 11% of 500,000 citizens currently getting access to pain relief and palliative care. This is according to the latest Lancet Commission report. This overwhelming gap has severe consequences, leaving patients to endure unbearable pain, psychological distress, and social loneliness. Palliative care refers to specialized medical care that focuses on providing relief from pain and other symptoms of a serious illness. It can help to cope with the side effects from medical treatments. The Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Health, Dr. Diana Twine, in a statement read by Director of Curative Services, Dr. Charles Olaro, acknowledges the challenge. According to the statement, access to palliative care is everyone's business, but remains a challenge with less than 15% of those in need receiving it, especially in low and middle income countries. Uganda has only 11%. The ministry recognizes palliative care as an integral part of our health system, and we remain committed to expanding those services at all levels of care, from national referral hospitals and specialized hospitals to Health Center 3 in the most remote areas of the country, she said. The World Hospice and Palliative Care Day will be commemorated tomorrow, Saturday, 12th October, and in Uganda, it has been a week-long commemoration with main activities held today, Friday, at Ntere Center in Ntinda. This year's theme is committed to strengthening palliative care as a component for comprehensive care in Uganda. The Executive Director of the Palliative Care Association of Uganda, Mark Donald Mwesiga, said that civil society organizations are crucial in advocating for palliative care, supporting the education and training of health workers, and providing services. He added that the Ministry of Health has made efforts to expand palliative care services, including increasing access to oral liquid morphine, a crucial pain management medication. Funding constraints still hinder the expansion of services and training for healthcare.